This is Rebecca Derubo, and this is our Depeche Mode weekend. Stay tuned for loads of great Depeche Mode videos like Pimps, Personal Jesus, Just Can't Get Enough. But first of all, see ya! Get enough there from Depeche Mode, and it's all because it is our Depeche Mode weekend, so make sure that you stay tuned to Awaken the Wild Side for lots of brilliant Depeche Mode videos and also some great information that you might want to know about the band. Well, they were actually brought up outside London in Basildon, a little weird little kind of town where nothing happened and all the kids kind of got together and started doing music together, and it was very successful indeed. This is a video from Depeche Mode that was directed by Anton Corbijn, Personal Jesus. this is our Depeche Mode weekend, and they're very fashionable people, aren't they, from that band? And if you are as well, well, you can check out The Pulse. Got a brand new edition, and today at 1400 CET, you can catch it. And this month's poll question is, who's the best dressed male pop star? I have to think about that one. Well, check out The Pulse later on at 2 o'clock. This is, of course, our Depeche Mode weekend. I got Walking in My Shoes coming up from the band. But first of all, this.
Depeche Mode's first album in 3 years will feature a lot of new wrinkles, including, believe it or not, a rock and roll song.
It's probably totally, completely the opposite to what anyone was expecting from Depeche Mode to put out. And I think that's a really good thing, because I think we've always challenged people with something different every time. And we put out a record, and I think this is again going to challenge a Depeche Mode fan and hopefully new people to come and listen to the album as well.
The rock song in question is, in fact, the first single, entitled I Feel You. The band's sequencers and computers were given a rest as Depeche Mode recorded the guitars, bass, and drums live.
I suppose it is quite different sounding for us. It probably surprised quite a lot of people. It is quite rocky, but it still has very much the stamp of Depeche Mode.
Another new wrinkle on Songs of Faith and Devotion is the use of additional musicians in the studio. Gospel singers on Get Right With Me, and on the song One Caress, Martin Gore singing along with a 28-piece string section. The track was recorded live in less than an hour.
He sang really well because he was competing against all these people as well. So it was really exciting to see that. I mean, it was like that was maybe 10 minutes of studio work in a whole year, you know, but it was a very special moment, yeah.
While Depeche Mode is happy with the results of its experiments using outside musicians, they say there were misgivings at first.
We've never actually found it easy integrating any new people into our setup. We're very insular in that way, so it would be challenging for us to do something like that. So we wanted to challenge ourselves in as many different ways as possible with this record, which is why it's ended up sounding so different to any of our other records.
Rockumentaries, live footage, it's all coming up all through today here in our Depeche Mode weekend. Next up, I have a video and a song that reached number 13 in the UK in 1983, March 1983. That's also the year when Depeche Mode went on a big, huge world tour, Canada, the US, Japan, they went everywhere. And here's that song, as promised, Get the Balance Right.
Yeah, you're listening to TH Radio, and we're talking about the death of the electric guitar. And I think, personally, that this is a fine example that the guitar is dead. Dead, dead, dead.
Central European time here in Awake on the Wild Side with our Depeche Mode weekend theme. Enjoy the Silence is coming up, and Master and Servant, World in My Eyes, but first of all, a question of time. World in My Eyes there from Depeche Mode. In an interview, the band was saying that the reason why they always write their songs in minor keys, I'm sure that if you're a musical person, you know where the minor key is. It's like a little bit more depressing key. And if you write in major, it's a bit more happy sounding. You understand? So they write all their songs nearly in minor keys. And it's because life is a little bit minor, the band thinks. It's all a little bit depressing, and you go up and down valleys and stuff. Well, I don't know if we agree with that. But anyway, here they are with Master and Servant, one of their biggest hits.
It's a lot.
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 Like.
Enjoy the silence there. I've got David Gahan, the lead singer, coming up very soon here, right on your screens, talking a little bit about life and work. And after that, the meaning of love. Very nice video from Depeche Mode, so here goes.
There's lots of areas of this business where you can become quite a nasty, horrible, disgusting person and not feel very good about yourself. The glamorous side of things, if you like, if you want to call it that, when you're on the road and you're wrapped up in cotton wool and everything's done for you and anything you want you can do and anything you need you can get, and it's this fantasy world that you live in for quite a while, and it's quite a reality shock when you come down from that and you have to go back to whatever your everyday life is, optional life completely. Everything. Depeche Mode were having an incredibly successful time with Violator, and we've done probably our most successful tour, and on that side of things we couldn't have been much higher. And then you suddenly go back home and things aren't quite as happening as they were, or you know, things have changed and that are quite painful to me to even talk about now, to be quite honest. I came back kind of really firing on all cylinders and wanting to make a record and to be able to express myself, express some of the feelings that I was having during that time through the songs and through with my voice. And I think, you know, I just said earlier as well, for the first time I really feel I sung really honestly, and you know, you really hear me all over this record, my voice, the stuff that, you know, I do anyway, but I mean in a good way. I can hear the pain that I was feeling a lot of the time, but also I can. There's a great sense of optimism. I don't know what it is. I mean, I feel that we're getting better and better at what we do. I think as musicians and working together, we certainly do. We definitely, our roles are certainly more defined, and everybody is able to have their space in the studio, and you know, everybody is heard. And I think that's something that's quite important to the success of Depeche Mode as well. That there's no real one dictator within the band who's, you know, telling everybody else what, how it's going to be. Well, there's nothing like it walking on stage in front of all those people. You can't help but let it go to your head and enjoy it, though, I mean, and then work from that and perform, and you just suddenly start doing things that you would never do if you're just standing next to somebody in a club or something. I think it's great that I'm able to throw some of that stuff out there. God knows what I'd do otherwise. I'd probably become a murderer or something with all that energy. But no, I have an opportunity to explore all different areas of my emotion. And some people don't get in touch with those emotions at all in their life. You do what you do with integrity, and you honestly feel it's the best you can do. All that other stuff, like the success and everything, I think will eventually happen, you know. You just got to keep trying. And if you start to sell yourself too much and you feel you're selling yourself too much with lots of different things that you don't feel comfortable about, you just end up, the band starts arguing, and you argue about what you're going to do. You argue about an interview or a TV show and things like that. And that's such a waste of energy when all our energy should be spent on making the music. And we're very fortunate that we've gained a lot of success over the years. And now we're able to very much pick and choose exactly what we want to do, and we're very privileged in that way. But I think we deserve it. It's cool. I think it's something we've earned, you know.
You're welcome if you just tuned in to our Depeche Mode weekend, and if you've been watching the show, well, I hope that you are enjoying it. Also, later on in the day, we've got rockumentaries coming up and all that, especially for you Depeche Mode fans. I've got to play you a video now that is one of my favourite Depeche Mode songs, at least. It reached number 4 in the UK in 1984, in April to be exact, actually. And this is People Are People. Little 15, Shake the Disease, Stripped. Yes, that's all great Depeche Mode videos that's coming your way very soon right here on Awake on the Wild Side. But first of all, Strange Love. Right, this is Wake on the Wild Side with the Depeche Mode Weekend. Sometimes Depeche Mode has been criticized for not playing totally live at their concert. That means that like some sounds has been on tape, recorded, etc. Well, the band answered that question by saying that so many sounds in their songs and there's just enough, not enough people on stage to play them all. So it's just an easier way to make the concert sounds 10 times better. As long as it sounds good, who cares? Anyway, here's Shake the Disease from Depeche Mode. Little 15 there from Depeche Mode. I've got a new video film that's coming up very, very soon that I like very much. Of course, it was directed by Anton Corbijn because they like him very much. And most of the videos has actually been directed by him. But before I play you that video, I want you to take a look at this.
Hello, Mexico.
Ljubljana.
Professor Liliki.
Hello, Milan.
Singapore.
Hello, Finland.
Just, it seemed like an interesting idea to sort of try and combine all our fans at one time across Europe and play them the record and, you know, link up with them, really.
I don't know what to expect, really.
Compared to Violator, it'll be far harder. It won't be as clean cut.
From the single, I think it's going to be a lot sort of deeper and meaningful, shall we say.
There's the risk of being asked a sort of a contentious question, but I mean, how much of a risk is that, really?
Where does Martin get his hair done?
I don't know, I'd ask him for the... I'd ask him. And I'd ask... Oh, I don't know.
I'd say, why does Dave Garner look like Jesus?
What's your fear when you write
the songs? Well, I mean, I really don't know what my intentions are when I write a song, other than just trying to communicate some emotion. So I just sit down and I write a song. And I don't know, you know, I have no intentions. I pick up a pen and I immediately touch on God within the first three lines, sex within the first five, you know, and that's how it goes.
Martin Gore's voice has improved masses. He's got a greater vocal range, definitely.
They could have done it on stage sort of thing for the people who've come down here instead of behind screens and that.
Okay, you two South and Zurich, what would you prefer as a support band? A Swiss yodeling band? Or a thrash metal band?
I don't think it'd be either of those possibilities. At the moment, it looks like...
We've got no idea.
No, we spoke tonight. Apparently, it looks like there's a very good possibility there's a band called Marksman opening up for the first half of the tour. And for the second half of the tour, it'll probably be a band called House of Pain. That looks like the they're the hot favourites at the moment.
I think they're having a good laugh because I don't think the questions are really sort of relevant. They're sort of pop star questions, they're not really that personal, really.
I think the question was, why have you changed your look, Dave?
No.
Oh, come on.
What do you mean, oh, come on?
You've got a lot of this, you've got a lot of this.
I've had a lot of this for a long while. My hair grew for a while. What more do you want me to say? The music's the most important thing, you know. That's it.
I think it is just more acoustic, but it's quite rocky in parts, but it's definitely not industrial, and thank God it isn't dance, really.
Are the rumours really true that you may be splitting up after this tour?
As far as I'm aware, we're not splitting up, but you never know, do you?
Shouts of space.